And so the celebration continued. Even after the matchup was over, Ric Flair, Mr. Perfect, celebrating in the dressing room. However, more damage was done to Randy Savage, as Randy Savage was left helpless in the ring.
All alone.
The official trying to help him get back to his feet. The damage has been done. From there, what would possess Razor Ramon to return to the ring? What kind of a human being is this man?
A very low human being.
A vicious man. A vicious man that probably got some input, some ideas from some other people. Got a little
good
direction
to do that.
He probably got it by you or you.
Well, Savage gave him a shot, knocked him off the podium.
He shouldn't have been out there in the first place.
Says who?
Throwing that toothpick around, talking about machismo-ism or whatever it is. Savage is not the kind of guy. He's on a fuse this short. Right. If you start throwing toothpicks in a man's face, he's going to stand up to himself. But then you got to give him credit. He went out there against Flair, one of the greatest technical wrestlers in the WWF, and put it all on the line.
Yeah, and with you at ringside snipping at him like a dog.
That's right.
And then from there, Razor Ramon coming down to ringside. Let's take you back now and show you what happened as Razor Ramon returns to ringside.
You laugh all you want.
You did a good job.
Well, we are back with the Macho Man, Randy Savage. This crowd cannot believe here in Hershey, Pennsylvania, what has happened. Ric Flair and... What is this man doing coming back to ringside? Razor Ramon. Hey, come on! Razor Ramon with a leg! Ramming that left leg down on the apron! What's going on? Why is he back down here? Razor grabbing the leg of Savage. Oh no! Rams it in a ring post! Well, where are the officials? Randy Savage. Macho Man Randy Savage could count on no one else. He could definitely count on the Ultimate Warrior.
Well, you know, when you go against a man face to face like Savage Warrior did in SummerSlam, you learn respect. You learn what's in a man's heart. You form kind of a bond between the two. So when Savage was down, it didn't surprise me that Warrior was the man.
You want to talk about bonds here in the World Wrestling Federation?
Yeah.
Take a look at Ric Flair, Bobby the Brain Heenan, and Mr. Perfect. Now, there's three guys. There's never been a stronger bond in the World Wrestling Federation.
That reminds me of another real strong bond between three men.
Now, who's that?
Larry, Curly, and Moe. The Three Stooges.
We'll be back for more WWF Primetime in just a moment.
Hey, I'm talking to you.